So when we think about Nerf, we think of bright blue, yellow, orange blasters, sometimes shaped like Fortnite guns now. And we think of them as big, clunky toys for kids to shoot foam darts at each other. But are they really just toys? So recently I saw a Jack Freedman video where he, you know, printed his own Nerf blaster on his 3D printer, which I thought that was cool. I have a 3D printer. I have an adult job where I have money. Not a lot of money. But, you know, money to buy stuff that I want to do. So I thought, why don't I do that? So, this is one of the ones I printed. This is the Captain Slug Indra. And it's a big boy. And I didn't just print this one. I printed this one. This one's the Esper. It's really cool. It's a handgun. Or hand blaster, or whatever the hobbyists call it. It's pretty cool. It's a chunky boy. And along with that, I printed it, this one for a friend. This one is Captain Slug's Flak blaster, which allows you to just crank it, prime it, and fire it. And all of these are really cool. And you might be wondering, who is Captain Slug? From what I understand, Captain Slug was one of the earliest Nerf hobbyist enthusiasts out there who helped build the community forward and help innovate the designs, as far as I understand. I wanted to make this video short because I don't really have a lot to say on this. I just printed the blasters, I built the blasters. I really wish I recorded myself building the blasters because it was really fun. And I do plan to do that in the future as I build more and increase my arsenal forward, but these are awesome. Just like the Flak. The Flak is a really cool one. It has this sci-fi looking aesthetic to it. Really nice, you know, shapes and everything. Really abstract. And it doesn't even look like a real gun. It just looks like a toy to me. This looks like a toy. But, like, you pump it. And then you fire. But this is the Flak, and then some of Slug's other designs, like the Indra, this one, are a little bit more refined. This one is modeled after a bolt-action sniper rifle. So you would take the handle right here, this part, the handle, you crank it back, like that, and it is loud. Crank it forward, which then, as you guys can see here, through the breech, it would then push the dart into position right there, leaving it the vacuum chamber in the back empty. But when you pull the trigger, and this is gonna be loud, but when you pull the trigger, it pushes the plunger forward at immense speed, using a spring, as you can see, a spring right here, pushing the plunger forward, allowing it to create enough force and enough air to be pushed through that it would have fired the dart through this, I think I ordered 13 inches of barrel. All of it aluminum, 13 inches of aluminum barrel. Pushing the dart out a great amount. Which that's really cool. And this one, the Indra. And I believe he also has a design called the Caliburn and the Talon Claw. That also uses a spring-loaded mechanism like that. And it's really cool. Like, this is really cool. This is a really amazing piece of DIY engineering, and it's really cool. And then, like, the first one I had built for myself was the Esper. Like, I got into this from Zach's video, and I was like, that looks cool. I'll just dip my toes in. I won't get into it too far. I'll buy the cheapest kit I could see there that's an actual, you know, mag-fed blaster. And I thought, I'll get the Esper. The Esper is only 40 bucks, I think. So I got the Esper, which is this. Which, just like the Flak, is also a string, elastic band loaded design. I think they call them stringers. Which, you pull this back, and you're wondering, where's the little chamber? The chamber is actually in the slide mechanism. So you pull that back, it locks the plunger in place. As you pull it, the plunger is now there. The vacuum chamber is now empty, plunger's in place, and it loads the dart into this area over here. You can't really see into the breach on this design, but it loads the dart in there, that when you fire it, it just forces air out, firing the dart outward, and it's really fun. Like, these are amazing for just a hobbyist grade type of toy. And I'm using the term toy loosely here because they hurt. They actually hurt. Like, these toys, they hurt. And I wouldn't recommend giving these to a kid or anything, but they're fun. So, here's the bad news though. Captain Slug isn't manufacturing the parts kits anymore. I printed all the shells myself, I printed all the body and parts like that myself, but I bought the hardware kits, the internal components, the rods, the chambers, everything like that from Captain Slug off his Etsy page, but from what I understand, he's moving to South Korea with his wife, and he won't be manufacturing them for about 3 years or so, due to international shipping costs and machining costs over there. So, if you, the viewer, whoever's watching this video, I don't even know if anyone's gonna watch this video, but this hobby makes me excited, and I can't wait to do more. But if you guys want to build some of these, Captain Slug's actually contacted a few people to start manufacturing these blasters for him. For example, the next one I ordered was the Caliburn. Like I mentioned earlier, the Caliburn has the same type of mechanism as the Indra. The Caliburn is now being manufactured by, I believe, Silver Fox Industries, who also manufactures parts and full kits for a bunch of other blasters, which is amazing. So, I want to end this video by saying thank you, Jack Freedman. Your videos are awesome. Your breakdowns and everything for the whole DIY maker community type stuff is amazing, and I wouldn't have known about 3D printing Nerf blasters if it wasn't for his video. And thank you to Captain Slug for helping the community, helping the whole hobby space get to this point with these amazing designs, just the whole pull back, it clicks into place, and then fire mechanism. Like, this is awesome. And, like, it's so easy to build and so much fun. And I'm enjoying it. And I want to build more. I probably won't go out and use them in public. I don't really have a group to do that yet. But if I did find a group, I'd obviously record videos of it. So thanks to Captain Slug for these amazing designs. Thanks to Jack Freedman for creating three amazing videos about DIY Nerf blasters. And yeah, I'd also like to thank all my Patreon supporters. Which, that's weird to say since I haven't made a video in a while, but I have 3 Patreon supporters and their names will be somewhere on the screen. And thanks to y'all, I'm able to work on stuff like this. This video took a little bit to get off the ground and get made for a couple reasons. I work to 40 hours a week just so I can afford to do projects like this. And along with that, just shipping times for our hardware parts, extra components, the print time on these just alone. Like, I think the Asper took about 40 print hours. The Indra took about 60. Like, I'm not kidding. I would just leave this printing while I'm at work. And I would have that going on my printer using Octoprint to just monitor my printer as it's going. Yeah, I can't wait to make more content about these things, make more videos about other projects, and I have more videos planned. For example, videos just around projects dealing with this, the Pi Pico, and around other projects I want to do, such as finishing up my Unity to Twitch chat or Twitch chat to Unity translation layer that I've been working on, which if you guys are watching me on Twitch, I'm probably working on that while streaming because that's how I want to pair my overlay. So I would like to thank you all for watching. I'd like to thank all my Patreon supporters and everyone who follows me on Twitter, Facebook, and other social medias for helping me actually be motivated to work on this type of stuff. And have a good day. Just enjoy the hobby, enjoy what you do, and I hope to see a lot of you guys' stuff online.